Pixel art is awesome. It's a fantastic choice for indie developers making 2D games, not just because of its timeless, beautiful look, but also because with the right style, it can be manageable for programmers or beginner artists. But what if I told you there is an even faster and easier way to make beautiful looking 2D art for your game, especially if you're a programmer or new to art? In this video, I want to convince you that perhaps the best art style for your game isn't pixel art, it's vector art. I like to think of vector art as the other side of the pixel art coin for small indie developers working on 2D game art. It's just as viable, if not more convenient, but it's often overlooked or brushed aside. Maybe it's because it lacks the legacy pixel art has with older games, or maybe it's because people have problems defining it. It often gets lumped in with HD 2D art, which isn't entirely wrong, but it misses the point of the style and its usefulness for indie devs. Vector art means the artwork was made using a vector software, like Adobe Illustrator, Affinity Designer, or my personal favorite, the free and open source Inkscape. These are powerful illustration tools originally meant for the more elegant and controlled shapes of graphic design. You draw with keyboard and mouse, just like with pixel art, but because of the vector-specific tools, the art styles you want to work in tend to be more simple, geometric, and elegant. In my opinion, it's easier to learn and helps you start making real art faster than pixel art does. That's the key idea I want to share here. Yes, pixel art has that nostalgic charm and timeless appeal, and it looks amazing, but with the right style, vector art can look just as great and sometimes even better. Think of games like Patapon, with its bold silhouettes and clean designs, or Loco Roco, full of elegant and colorful shapes. These are perfect examples of classic vector style. Then there is Castle Crashers, Alien Hominid, Dad and Me, one of my favorites, and other behemoth games made and drawn with Flash, if I'm not mistaken. And of course, mobile hits like Kingdom Rush, Angry Birds, Cut the Rope, and King of Thieves. All of these likely use vector tools to make the art. Some great indie games were even made directly with Inkscape, like Crashlands, Levelhead, and other Butterscotch Shenanigans games. And that's just the ones that almost sure they were made with vector software. There are probably a ton more that we don't know, but looking at the art style makes me suspicious. Games like Among Us, Hollow Knight, The Binding of Isaac, they all look vector made to me. The point is, you can create beautiful game art with vector graphics. And there are more advantages too. Vector styles often rely on simplified, clean designs that are very easy to learn. Even if you can't draw, vector art thrives on graphic simplicity. That makes it super beginner friendly. Another huge benefit is reusability. Because of how vector objects are built, they are naturally modular and easy to reuse, perfect for game development workflows. I'd even argue that vector tools give you more flexibility than pixel art when it comes to picking a style. For instance, compare the level of detail in Kingdom Rush versus Monster Ate My Birthday Cake. Love the name, by the way. Both look great, but one is clearly faster and easier to produce, something critical for solo devs or small teams. And with the right tutorials, you'll be making solid game art much faster than you would with pixel art. Art like the one in Patapon or Loco Roco are completely doable, and I can show you how. I have a ton of friendly beginner tutorials here on the channel, both on the program and on game art in specific. For example, I can recommend you checking out Create RPG and Strategy Game Assets Top-Down House Tutorial for a simple introduction to top-down graphics, and Create a Stylized Isometric Island covering isometric art basics. Both are heavily inspired by mobile game art and designed for beginners to follow along step by step. In fact, I have a ton of these step-by-step tutorials. I'll leave you a link to the playlist down below. Also, over the next few weeks, I'll be releasing a whole new batch of step-by-step beginner tutorials on game art, covering everything from top-down and platformer graphics to user interface design and more. So if that's something you're interested, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. And if you're curious about going deeper, I've also created several game art-focused Inkscape courses. You can grab them all, including 13 additional Inkscape courses, in a massive bundle currently on sale for a limited time. Your support really helps me keep creating these free tutorials. So, hopefully I managed to convince you to give it a try to learn vector art. You have a ton of free resources right here on the channel alone, and much more on YouTube and other sources. Plus, to help you get started, I've also put together a free vector starter kit. It includes useful kit bashing assets, filled with pre-made assets to get you started with backgrounds and characters, a created list of high-quality tutorials and learning resources, and a few other miscellaneous documents with useful illustration goodies. You can find the download link in the description. And that was it for this video. Hopefully I see you in the next tutorial, which will be all about game art. Thanks for watching. Bye!